Hi everyone, welcome to the Analyzing Census Data in SAS Studio tutorial series. In the last two videos, I downloaded data on median home values in each state, then imported this data into SAS Studio. Now that I have a SAS table that I can use, I'll show you how you can create a bar chart using the bar chart task to have a visual to compare median home values across states. We'll also look at editing the code generated by the bar chart task to further enhance the results. If you want to follow along with me, make sure you watch the introduction video to set up your environment and tutorial data. You can find the link to it below or on the main tutorial page. Let's get started. So in SAS Studio, I have the census.median_home_value table opened up. We're just gonna take a quick look at this table before we jump into the bar chart task. Now, if you didn't follow along with the previous tutorial where I imported in this data, no worries at all. You can instead use the census.median_home_value_s table and follow along using that. Looking at this table here, we have one row for each state, and we have this column median home containing those median home values. What I want to do with the bar chart task is essentially provide a visual of this information to make it easier to compare these median home values. Let's jump into the task. In the navigation pane, I'm going to expand the tasks and utilities section. And under tasks, I'm going to expand the graph category and then double click bar chart. This opens up the bar chart task in a new tab in the work area. And by default, the view is set to split. So I see the settings on one side and the code and results on the other side. I'm going to keep that as is, but I'm going to click on the maximize view button. And that's going to hide the navigation pane and just provide me with a little bit more room to work with. So the first thing I need to do on the settings side, specifically under the data tab, is specify my input table. Now you'll notice that my input table census.median_home_value is already selected, but if you don't see that, click on the select the table button, expand that census library, select the median home value table or the _s version, and click OK. On that data tab, next to chart orientation, I'll keep this as a vertical bar chart. So let's move on to our task roles. Our task roles determine how our columns will be used within the task. We have a couple of roles here, but take a look at the category role. The category role has a red asterisk next to it, which means that it is a required role. I have to assign some sort of column to this role. Now remember, I want to create a bar chart with one bar for each state, the height representing that median home value. Because I want one bar for each state to my category role, I'll assign that state column. So I'll click on the plus sign, which is add a column, select state, and click OK. Next, for my measure role, that determines the height of the bars. The default is just a frequency count, but again, I want those median home values. So from the drop-down list, I will select variable. And to the variable role, I will assign the median home column and click OK. Now for the statistic that is used, the default is the sum. And we're actually going to use that statistic because we only have one median home value per state. The sum of one value is just the value itself. So again, we're going to stick with that sum. Now, there is a lot more options that we can take advantage of in the bar chart task, and we'll explore some of those coming up. But for now, let's take a look at the code tab. This task, the bar chart task, generates proc sgplot code behind the scenes for us, and we can see that right here on that code tab. At this point, let's go ahead and give this code a run. Let's see what we have so far. So I'll click run. Now, looking at the bar chart, we have a start here, but we could probably make some improvements. Right, I have one bar for each state. The height represents the median home value. That's good. But I can see that all of my state names are being overlapped with each other. I might want to expand the width of this graph to make sure that they aren't overlapping. Maybe I'd like to add in the title, and maybe I can change the label of the y-axis, for example. To make these changes, I'm just going to go back to the settings side. Specifically, now we're going to the appearance tab to make these changes. First, to change the label on my y-axis median home, I'm going to expand the measure axis heading. Then from the Display Label drop-down list, I will select Custom Label. In the label box, let's label this median home value. Next, the title. I'll expand the title and footnote heading. And let's call the title median home value in 2018. Finally, the graph size. I'll expand the graph size heading. And for the width, let's bring that up to 10 inches. And I'll leave the height at the default 4.8 inches. Let's run it again. Let's see how our bar chart changes. This is looking a lot better now. My state names are no longer overlapping. There's more room for it to work with. I see my median home value label on my y-axis and a nice title as well. Now, you might have noticed that when I ran it the second time, next to my bar chart tab, there's actually a warning icon. If you see an icon like this, it's always a good idea to take a look at your log. So let's jump into the log tab. I see there are two warnings here, and they say that the width exceeds available space for RTF, which is like the Word format, and the PDF destination setting width equal to 8 inches. So what does that mean? Well, by default in SAS Studio, our results get generated in the HTML5, RTF, and PDF results. What these warnings are saying is that for the RTF and PDF format specifically, that width of 10 was too wide, so it just set it to 8 automatically. This does not affect our results though, because on the results tab, we are only viewing the HTML5 results. But it's always good to make sure you check your log to see if there's any warnings or errors you might want to be aware about. I'm going to go back to the results tab, taking a look at my bar chart again. Now this time, what I'd like to do is maybe plot the US median home value as a reference line in this bar chart. I don't know what that US median home value is, and it's not a part of my data, but data.census.gov makes it really, really easy to find that information. So in a new tab, I'll go to data.census.gov. This is a great resource to access data that the Census Bureau makes available. And what I'll do this time is in the freeform single search bar, I'm going to just type in exactly what I'm looking for, which is median home value 2018. Let's see what we get. Now, previously I was looking at tables, but I actually don't even need to look at a table to get the information that I'm looking for. You'll notice at the top of the All Results page, it immediately tells me that the median housing value in 2018 was $229,700. So that was really easy for me to get. With that in mind, let's go back into SAS Studio. On the Appearance tab, let's add in that reference line. Under the Measure Axis heading, which is already expanded, I'm going to check the checkbox for Create a Reference Line and type in that value. $229,700. Let's add in a custom label as well, and I will label that as US median. Let's give it a run. So I get pretty much the same bar chart, but now I have that US median home value plotted as a reference line in green. This makes it pretty easy to see which states are above the US median home value or below it. Now let's take that a step further. Instead of plotting the US median home value as a reference line, maybe I want to filter my values based off of that. So only plot the states that have median home values exceeding the US median home value. To do this, first I'm going to clear that reference line. So I'll clear the Create a Reference Line checkbox on that Appearance tab. To filter my data, I'm going to the Data tab, and right below my input table, I'll click Filter. In the Filter Expression box, I will type in median home, that's the name of the column, is greater than 229,700. The syntax that is used here in the Filter Expression box is based off of the SAS SQL Procedures WHERE clause, just without that WHERE keyword. If you're interested to learn more about that syntax, take a look at the tutorial notes. There is a link to the documentation there. But this is good to go for me, so I will click Apply. And let's run it again. So in my updated bar chart, I now see less states. These are states that have median home values exceeding that $229,700. So my bar chart's looking pretty good so far, but you'll notice right now that my bars are sorted in ascending or alphabetical order by the states. Maybe instead I'd like to sort my bars by the median home value instead of by the states. Well, let's take a look at the tabs to see if there's any options for that. So let's take a look at the appearance tab. And under the category axis heading, let's see what we have. So there's an option, reverse tick values. What that'll do is sort the bars in reverse or descending order by the states. Not quite what we want. And then there's show tick values in data order. So sort the bars or the states in order in which it appeared in the input table itself. But there isn't an option that lets me sort my bars by those median home values. If there is an option or setting that you're looking for that you're not finding in the task itself, what you can do is go in and modify the code that was generated by this bar chart task. If I go to the code tab, there's that code that we want to modify. Before I go in and do that, there's one more resource I'd like to show you, and that is on the information tab. I mentioned earlier that the bar chart task generates proc SG plot code. And if you're not very familiar with it, you want to learn more about it, that information tab actually has a direct link to the documentation that talks about the SG plot procedure. So you might want to check that out. But for now, let's go back into the code tab. Now the code tab, this is a read-only copy of the code. If I want to make a modifiable copy, I can just click on edit. This opens up a new program tab that is again modifiable, so I can make some edits to the code that was generated. So you might not be familiar with SAS code, but SAS Studio actually has a lot of features available that make it a little bit easier for you to code and has some features to help guide you. So I'd like to show you a couple of those features. First, let's say in my code, I'm not very familiar with this VBAR statement, but I want to learn more about it. What you can do, go ahead and right-click on the VBAR keyword and select Syntax Help. The Syntax Help window tells me a little bit about this VBAR statement. So the description says it creates a vertical bar chart that summarizes the values of a category variable. And I can also see the syntax. After that VBAR keyword, I list a category variable. And then after a forward slash is where all of my options are going to go. So you might be wondering, well, what are some options that are available? Is there something that I could take advantage of to sort my bars by the median home values? Well, let's see. I'm going to place my cursor right before the semicolon on that VBAR statement. You just want to make sure you're after that forward slash because, again, we're interested in those options. When I hit the space bar, an autocomplete window opens up and shows me all the valid options for a VBAR statement. And there are a lot of options I can take advantage of here. The one that I'm interested in is the category order equals option. So I'm going to hit the C on my keyboard. It takes me right to the C's, and now you see category order equals is highlighted. Now I have the syntax help window for the category order equals option. I see that it specifies the order in which the response values or median home values are arranged. That's exactly what we want. So with the category order equals option highlighted in my autocomplete window, I can just hit the enter key, and now the category order equals option is automatically added into my program, which is nice. Then autocomplete opens up again. Now I can see the valid option values for the category order equals option. RESP ASC and RESP DESD. So response ascending or response descending. I'm going to single click on response descending so I can read more about it. As you can probably guess, it sorts the response values in descending order. That's exactly what I want. So this time I will double click it. And that also adds in that value to my program. So the syntax help window and the autocomplete window can guide you out and help you out as you're typing inside of a SAS program. There's one more thing I'd like to add in here, and that is a secondary title explaining the filter that was applied. So right below the title statement, I'm going to add a title to statement, and in quotes, type in the title. I'll say states exceeding US median of $229,700, and then end that statement with a semicolon. Let's give the program a run. So here is my final bar chart, again, only looking at the states that exceed that US median home value of $229,700, and now it is sorted in descending order by those median home values. At this point, you may want to share this bar chart in, let's say, a PDF format, for example. Earlier, I mentioned that by default, SAS Studio generates our results in the HTML5, PDF, and RTF formats. In order to access those, there are these buttons on the results tab to download the results as an HTML file, PDF file, and an RTF or a Word file. As an example, let me show you the PDF file. Just click on the button, open that up, and now I have the same exact bar chart, but now in a PDF file, which might make it a little bit easier to share with your colleagues. I'll go ahead and close out of my PDF file. And let's save our work. I'm going to first exit out of Maximize View, bring back my navigation pane, and to save the program on the Code tab, I'll click on the Save icon. Let's save it in the Census Data Analysis folder. I will call this program Median Home Bar Sort, and click Save. Closing out of the program, let's also save the settings specified in the bar chart task. Click the Save icon here as well. And in that Census Data Analysis folder, let's call this one Median Home Bar, and click Save. Now you know how to create a bar chart using the bar chart task to visualize census data. Make sure to try out the practices in the tutorial notes. To learn how to create a stacked bar chart, check out the challenge practice. You'll even edit the code generated by the bar chart task to create a stacked bar chart where each bar equals 100%. Thanks for watching.